Are we live?
Not yet, but I'm sorry.
Oh.
Hey, Pascal, we're live now. In our
are we live? We're live?
Live.
Awesome.
Hallelujah, yes. It worked, guys. We're just a few minutes late, so if you're catching us here, my apologies. It just wasn't seeming to work out with the audio. And now we're here. So we're holding space
awesome.
For regenerative detox chats and questions about regenerative healing. I got my fellow detox specialist and dear friend Pascal here with me today.
Thank you. Let's talk about health.
Okay, well, Pascal.
And food.
I am so excited. First, for those of you who don't know me, I just want to introduce myself. So my name is Janetta Nakini. I'm a regenerative detoxification specialist. I'm certified through the International School of Healing Arts, and I'm a clinical iridologist. So you're so welcome here. I'm so grateful, Pascal, for you to join me these lives every 2 weeks. And I wanted to ask you, you know, I've been really thinking a lot. Where do you get your protein?
Where do I get my protein?
Isn't it very important to have
yeah,
so
I get
much
asked
protein?
That all the time, let me tell you. So, I mean, you know what? I think it's true. It's a myth. This protein info that people talk about all the time. I think it's been pushed by the meat industry, the protein industry. You know, they're just pushing, you know, this, we have this obsession, this idea that that the body needs protein. Well, that's true, but it's not what you think. In fact, the body creates its own protein chains with what amino acids?
So wait, you're not eating a whole bunch of dead animal flesh and building your protein structures that way?
Of course not. And you know what I believe? I'm pretty sure that because of the protein molecule are so long and complex, I think they create free radicals in the body. And this, we all know that it causes cancer and all these other complications, but I'm pretty sure, you know, it's all this tissue, all this matter that the body can't really utilize. So, and the body, the GI tract doesn't like meat. So it's trying to get rid of it real fast. Just like true carnivores, their stomachs are really short. That's not the case for us. But, you know, because meat is so acidic, it's got to go through the mouth and then out it goes as soon as possible because it's very acidic. But the point is that the body creates its own protein molecules with amino acids. And the number one thing that there's a lot of the amino acid is fruits and vegetables. So it's not really an issue. And
what apparently gives them their structure. Yeah, Pascal? Like a vegetable or a fruit wouldn't even have a structure if it wasn't all amino acids. Yeah.
Right, exactly. And that's what it is. That's what protein is. It's the actual walls.
The wall. So when we build protein in our body, it's actual like muscle tissue. So when we look at like a strong animal, you know, who just eats grass all day, even a cow, for example, how are they so muscular? We get so much meat from them, right? Think about the beef industry, guys. Yeah, this is all protein, right? Well, did they build their protein by eating other cows, or did they build it by eating greens that are filled with amino acids?
Exactly. So,
and look at those ninja guys and gals that throw themselves from monkey bar to monkey bar. You've probably seen some documentaries, and it's more about eating plant-based, these documentaries. I don't know the names right off the bat, but these athletes, holy Lord, that are plant-based, even a gorilla, guys, you know, they say we're 97% the same, 98% the same anatomy as the primates. This is why we're a frugivory species. And, you know, a gorilla can actually tear you apart. Yeah, they're super strong. And their diet is primarily fruits and a little bit of dark leafy greens. So maybe once in a while, some people have challenged me, oh no, they eat bugs and stuff. That's their protein. And I'm like, I can assure you they're not the size they are because they're eating a few bugs when they get pushed up into the mountains and have no other food supply, you know. But their main food source is fruits, just like us, and dark leafy greens. Mm. How cool is that? And we, sorry, Pascal, give me one second.
Okay, let's move away from this. We've answered the protein myth.
We have, and we're here for you guys to answer any of your questions. So this is a space for our members at the Raw Reset to answer any questions pertaining to transitioning over to a more raw lifestyle, a raw whole food living lifestyle of abundance, I guess I'm calling it today. So
can I jump in and I just want to mention the biggest secret. Ooh. Is it the biggest secret or the
best kept secret?
Can I just the best kept secret? Sure. And I think I'll whisper a little bit because, you know, we don't want to talk about this a whole lot. Well, here we can, actually.
Who do we not want to hear? Only for those who are ready.
So, but no, that's the thing. The best kept secret is that the only food for consumption is fruits and vegetables. That's a pretty big statement.
These are the foods that actually move through us very easily and effortlessly. You talk about the GI tract. Yeah, 35-foot-long GI tract. Everything has to travel through, whereas a carnivore, it's mouth to anus, you know, one tube. They can process a lot of animal flesh, not like us. So that's a beautiful secret to share with us. Thanks, Pascal.
You're welcome.
I have been in a bit of a funk because, of course, many of us have been feeling into this heavy energy that has been these times, you know, the last couple of years. And we're in Canada, so we have Health Canada, which is a $1 billion business, I'm going to call it. And yeah, they really have to uphold this facade of being leaders in health. And so they're really implementing things very harsh here, I find, compared to other countries. And I've been thinking a lot into a lot of this negativity and really channeling this down, because I know Pachamama takes this from me, guys. It just moves. It moves through us, yeah? Emotions are energy in motion. So I have been contemplating a little bit with my mind's eye and seeing some really expanded view of where we could go because of the light that's being shone, you know, on all of this darkness now. I mean, everything comes into fruition now. Everyone sees what's happening out there. And, you know, I mean, my frustration with the medical system started because I couldn't find answers for myself. I was sick all my childhood, upper respiratory, chronic sinuses, bronchioles. I was on inhalers. You know, my doctor, he was relatively good as a child. Like, he wasn't giving me too much. He wouldn't even diagnose it as asthma, but these were the symptoms, you know. And I actually had to ask him for a puffer because I was like, can't I have anything to feel better? I just didn't know better, you know. I was so young. And that's where the frustration started. And then watching my father later in life get diagnosed with lupus made me really, really upset, because it's like they created a whole umbrella term for any set of symptoms they just really don't understand. And they call these autoimmune diseases, right? I don't believe in diseases. I believe in states of dis-ease. Well, they call this a disease, an autoimmune disease, which I believe takes away the power from the individual to actually realize that this is not my body attacking itself, because that's what they're saying, okay? This is actually a condition that I created through lifestyle and dietary choices. So how are you doing? Like, because you're out in Ottawa, things are pretty intense there from what I understand. Any thoughts about what I had just mentioned there.
Yeah, well, I think we're in a lockdown right now. And I think this time around, people are kind of, you know, it's difficult for everyone. It's been difficult for me as well.
Thank you for sharing.
But, you know, the way I see it is that it's this new, I mean, I don't want to, this new world's come, there's a new thing coming out. There's the negative, but there's the positive. Absolutely. And things are polarizing. So
that's kind of the 3D realm though, right? There's only two sides in the 3D.
Yeah.
As five-dimensional beings, you know, I agree that there's a lot of expansion that comes from this. I didn't mean to interrupt you.
No, but so it's basically just focusing on the positive. There is the negative. We have to learn how to deal with it. Honor it. Yeah.
Channel it down to her because she can take it, guys. What do we think? We're going to process negativity in the third dimension? Good luck. Right. It's not on us to do that. We process it by feeling it, but yeah, we send it right down, you know, to be transmuted at the core of the earth into this almost like this golden version, like this higher self voice. You know, this is what I've been working with these times being so heavy, you know, but I wanted to really focus on this idea, this false notion of autoimmune and how that kind of traps us. And when we realize that there's just a chronic state of acidosis that are leading to a set of uncomfortable symptoms, poor health symptoms that they're then calling autoimmune because they can't get to the bottom of it. Like, for example, fibromyalgia, the whole body is in pain. I've met individuals, they live with this for years and years thinking that it came from Moose Jaw, Alaska, as Dr. Morse would say, and chose to attack them. And now they're a victim of this. Well, really what this is if you take a little bit of your blood and you put it under a microscope, you have a red blood cell analysis, you're gonna see even the blood that always has to be alkaline or you literally die, even the blood is affected by acids because you'll see your red blood cells, your erythrocytes stacked in rolls of coins. And so acids agglomulate, they stick everything together. So think about cells as like little people. They need their blood and their lymph surrounding them. That allows them to breathe and they can't have too many other cells too close. You know, it's like people, you have your personal bubble, you know, of protection. Well, with the acidity, they all get stuck together and there's no room to breathe. It's almost like taking a blanket and putting it over someone and say, okay, breathe now, you know? So what I'm talking about is the lymphatic system has to be addressed because this is where we really can see the level of lymphatic stagnation. And there's really only one science that shows this, and the medical system poo-pooed the whole thing, guys. It's not even, the great lymphatic system is not even discussed in medical literature. Yet every cancer is a lymphoma. So how does that make any sense? So hear me say that over and over because people understand this when I say this. So I'm learning to speak in a way that's simple for people. And even though I'm not super intelligent, but this is my one area of specialty. You know, I've been studying the alkaline acid balance since 2011 when I went off to Germany to train as an alkaline coach. And with iridology, the science of the iris, we're able to see the different levels of lymphatic stagnation. And this is where we really need to focus to get people out of states of dis-ease, including any autoimmune. You know, they get relief relatively quickly with our program. So if you're catching us live, guys, please do say a hello, drop anything in the comments. Pascal and I are here to answer any of your questions and chat about regenerative healing.
Okay, so let me ask you about autoimmune disease.
Okay.
It seems It seems like it's there's a whole bunch of different symptoms associated to this it seems like a cloud of or a just a blanket term autoimmune, because arthritis is considered autoimmune, even irritable bowel syndrome is considered autoimmune. So I'm trying to translate that into my own knowledge of the lymphatic system. So the lymphatic system is the fluid, right? When we say 80% water, our body is. This is the liquid we're talking about. And it is, I mean, if you dissect a body, you can't see it because it's water. Is it? Is that true?
Yeah, you and I talked a lot about like this black matter, like this space that exists within us. But I really believe the lymph is a fluid, just like a body of water that is moving through us. Maybe they're choosing not to see it. We have some questions too about our little chat on protein. Do you mind if we go backwards for a sec?
Sure.
Christina asks, so I was taught in holistic nutrition, because, you know, there's registered holistic nutritionists here in Ontario, right? And in Canada in general. And so she's trained with one of the schools here, and she's asking, because they taught her that vegetables don't have a complete amino acid profile, and that they have to combine it. You have to combine your vegetables with grains like rice and pasta to get your full spectrum of amino acids. She wants to know our opinion. Thank you, Christina. Love you. I'm so happy that you're on this journey with us. Thank you for choosing to be here on the earth at this time and participate in finding truth when it comes to healing. And thank you for your question.
Well, obviously you want, you know, when you're eating fruits and vegetables, there's so many to choose from. And that's why a variety is going to give you a maximum potential, I suppose.
What would you say in terms of like having the most amino acids? Is it dark leafy greens? If they're really looking to build on plants, from what I know, like, you know, some of the leaders in raw foods are really into this gorilla milk. And so, Christina, they're using real dark leafy greens and coconut milk. And also the other combo for a complete amino acid profile makes a complete protein are just bananas and dates together in one meal. And these are builders. Coconut is a builder, and avocado. So this is what I know, because we're in a real cold time of year, right? So in the Northern Hemisphere, we have winter right now. It's January, I believe it's the 19th today. And so maybe some of us want to stay a bit more warm with these more dense, plant-based foods. Just remember that when we do have a meal like that, we're not actually in a detoxification mode.
Okay, let's look at that a little bit, because, okay, we're in a cold climate. We want to feel full. We want maybe warmer foods. Is it possible that we are, this only gives us let me formulate what I'm trying to say. Because,
yeah, it's nice to take a few breaths before we talk. I can hear
you. So protein is about tissue, rebuilding tissue, right? That's why if you still want to work out on a raw diet, then do a lot of vegetable juices. But what does the body really need? Mm-hmm. You know, what does the cell eat? Mm-hmm. correct me if I'm wrong, but is it ATP?
Yes, adenosine triphosphate. This is all we really run on.
Is ATP, is it carbon with some oxygen?
It is, because that's what I believe that's just energy. ATP is just our energy that we create, but it's from carbon and oxygen.
Okay.
That we create.
So this protein issue, or this protein subject, is individual cells don't consume protein for energy. I think they can.
It takes a lot of work to break down
protein. And that's breaking down the walls. Yeah.
Yeah, so breaking down the logs that build the cabin wall. Yeah, why would you burn the logs that build the cabin wall?
Sure. So what I'm trying to get at is, okay, we need protein, but why not focus on what the cell eats?
Right, right.
Because the protein is the cell walls.
That's correct.
And that means rebuilding. But if you're clogged up and need to detox, then, you know, you can eat vegetables all day, but that won't detoxify you. It'll fill you up. So I'm just trying to analyze a little bit the what we're focusing in on, you know. Obviously,
I think that was really helpful. And I think we can go back to our chat on the lymph system, because this is where your hope is, everyone who's tuning in, whether you're here live or catching the recording. You actually have some hope when coaches like us come to you and say, don't worry, there's no disease. There's just states of dis-ease. Your body's just not at ease. And there's this giant pool of water that connects everything. You know, the shoulder is connected to the chest, is connected to the stomach. Like, everything is connected with this body of water. And the majority of people's eyes I've had the honor to look at, you know, the lymph is the biggest issue, along with the bowels. So we need to just give you this hope that if you focus on making your body more alkaline, your lymphatic system starts to move like a pool of water that hasn't gone stagnant, right? It's actually moving. It's more appealing. It doesn't seem as, you know, congested. And by getting your lymph moving, you're actually moving out a lot of waste. I like how you said it in your last call with Candy Pascal, where you were like, things eventually start to just loosen up. We start to, you know, stagnation and congestion, things sticking together. Picture your fascia, you know, all this webbing that connects all your muscles and skeletal system. Everything starts to release. Now there's more movement. There's more flow. The cells have space around them. This is when healing.
Yeah. And when that happens, you also see the real ailments of your body.
All the weaknesses are shown.
Yeah.
They're brought right in front of your face. Love it.
Scary.
So who's ready to come on the detox trade and have some healing reactions where you actually will jump for joy because you're in charge? You're on the botanicals, you're on the living foods, and now you have a sore throat or you have some ear congestion and you can say, hallelujah, my body's getting something out. I didn't pick something up from somewhere. I'm exposed to virals, bacteria everywhere, every day. You know, I'm actually just purging something. So it's uncomfortable on its way out. There will be pain. There will be discomfort. I mean, if you're interested, I can show, I don't know if you guys are interested, drop in the comments. I can show one of my clients who gave me permission to use her iPhotos.
Yeah, let's get into that. I think we've got
about 15 minutes left here.
Okay.
So keep the questions coming. Love that you're engaging in the chat, guys. Thank you so much. It's so nice to have you live. And if you're catching the recording, let us know your thoughts. How are you doing? Are you adopting a more living food lifestyle of abundance. I will share my screen. And we'll check out the dear one's beautiful irises. Or iris, let's see. Got the left eye. And we got the right eye. Make it bigger. So this was an interesting iris to analyze, because she has quite a bit of these Sora spots, we call them in iridology, based on Dr. Bernard Jensen's work. He practiced iridology for over 75 years, very well respected, dear friend of our mentor, teacher, and friend, Dr. Robert Morse. And what we see with these Sora spots, these dark spots, first of all, they're chemical deposits. Not this one, this is a lacuna. We'll talk about that after. But these ones here, these are passed on from our genes. So ancestors might have passed them on, maybe someone working in a coal mine. This is really high levels of chemical toxicity here. And you could delve more deeper into like where each one is located. So this is the right eye. So just to the right at 6 p.m., but just to the right of that is the kidney and the adrenal. And this person has quite a strong, like medium to strong genetic constitution, because we see that the fibers are relatively close. They're not big flowery shapes that we see in some really poor genetic constitutions. So this person would find that health and healing would come relatively easy to them when they're on the correct diet for our species, as well as herbal medicine. And this Sora spot is right on her right kidney. So there's some kind of chemical deposit, but yet I don't see any genetic weakness. So it may or may not cause her trouble. A detox reaction for her might involve a sore right kidney because of that chemical deposit. However, her kidneys should be filtering very well. If she collected her urine, just like in our files, if you want, you can look for kidney filtration, that document, and that'll show you how to test to make sure your kidneys are filtering waste, and you'll see it as sediment in your urine. So that's a really fun, cool test. This here, this is more a genetic weakness. These real dark, we call them lacunas. So I'd have to use my, you know, my iris chart and map it out all correctly. And I've already done her iris analysis. I just don't have it really with me. And I'm not like as pro as Dr. Morse to just start telling you what's at 11 o'clock and 12 o'clock. I do know that 12 o'clock is the brain, and we see a lot of congestion here in terms of lymphatic stagnation all through the bowels. All of this brown is chronic lymph, and all of these lacunas are genetic weaknesses. So it's kind of a fun science, guys. We have this at our fingertips. We're really happy to share. If you guys need iris photos, let us know. If you can come in person, Toronto or Ottawa, we can do that for you. And also I believe Candy does it out in Tennessee. So depending on where in the world you are, we can maybe do it for you. Otherwise, you just send us a high quality macro lens image and we can take it from there. So you'd have to take your own iris photos. This is the left eye. Any comments or anything you'd like to ask Pascal or anyone viewing this? Let us know your questions.
Well, I'm interested in the color of the bowels.
Yes, yes.
So is that the actual color of the lymph?
Yeah, so chronic lymph shows up as brown, acute shows up as white, acute is white, subacute is yellow. I think I have that in the right order. And what I see here is this is actually a blue eye. So there's only brown and blue eyes. When you meet this individual in person, her eyes appear to be brown. And I just got the permission to share another set of irises that are blue, that when you see the person, they look more green. I've always loved your eyes, Christina. Thank you for your permission. She's viewing, she's on the live with us now. She gives me permission to share her eye photos. Thank you, Christina. Love you so much. You're doing great work. Really so grateful for you. I was just thinking today, like, what did I deserve to have this new, beautiful sister in my life? Not that you're new. We've known each other for years, but we've come back together. And that is so beautiful. So these are recent eye photos of our dear friend, Christina. And she also has quite a strong genetic constitution, medium, you know, I would say medium to strong. And these are nerve rings that you see. So this means you really have a stress on the autonomic nervous system. So we'd ask you to really chill out, you know, Christina, like you don't have to do everything all the time. Just lying around is also really good, you know.
Oh, I think I can see the kidney because that's a right eye, right?
This actually is the left eye. So around 6 o'clock, she does have, yeah, it's some adrenal. Let's check. Oh, no, you're right. That is the right eye. Yeah, so it's okay. It's kidney. Thank you.
Yeah, right there. Out. Now, right, that looks like a...
Give me an adrenal.
To me, it looks like a crater. Can you talk a little bit about that, how it shows up?
Yes. So it shows up, they call them lacunas, these real dark, because so that's genetic weakness there, that lacuna. And what you see here, this one's open. See this one here? It's closed. Mm-hmm. That means it's healing. This lacuna is a little bit open. We want that to close. And then we want that to start healing. Yeah. From what I've learned, that's the case. And I have your iris analysis somewhere, Christina, and we could share a bit more on it in the future. What I was really fascinated with is this animation lifeline right at 12 o'clock here on the left eye. And I find that there's more of an emotional reason for this. And this is for very tapped in spiritual individuals. And Christina, you're definitely this giant being who knows that she's so connected and guided and supported by source, you know. And yeah, it can, even though it arises as a physicality, like a weakness in the physicality, it actually is a strength in terms of your spiritual body. It's almost like because there was this weakness right through the pineal gland, it opened you up. The weakness forced you to be tapped in more than others, I would say. So that's really beautiful. And I love that about you. And I see that in your way of life. So let's see. Christina says, how cool to see that on my iris. Yes, it is cool, dear one. Thank you for being open to this level of healing.
Could you point to the kidney?
Okay, so this is the left eye. Yeah, so 6 o'clock. So we have kidney here.
So is it, I mean.
It looks worse on the right eye.
Okay.
So you might have more trouble, Christina, on your right side of your body. You might have, like, for instance, I get a lot of pain in my right jaw. That's definitely connected to the weakness in my right kidney because we're so backed up. So the body's bilateral. So you filter the right side through your right kidney and the left side is filtered through the left kidney. So thank you, Christina, for letting me share your beautiful irises. That was really generous. Thank you, Pascal, for chatting with me about this. We have 5 more minutes. So anything you'd like to share or add, Pascal? I'm so curious about you. How are you doing?
Things have been okay. What did I want to talk about? Sorry. Well, I've been, so what I'm trying to do is, I've never been pretty big on eating nuts. And I remember a couple of years ago, I ate a homemade Nutella, and my throat swelled up, right? And I said, oh geez, you know, that's not good. Am I allergic to hazelnuts and blah blah blah. But right now, I've basically started using nuts and seeds and place them instead, or just use them as a like replace them at like junk food. It's like the junk food of a
raw diet. Yeah,
that's how I see it. And
absolutely
dried fruit, and it kind of helps with the emotional eating, right? When you're anxious, when you feel a bit nervous, it's easy to just start eating something, right? So anyways, I just wanted to point that out. And the fact that I'm really trying to see the big picture in terms of a raw diet. And when times get tough, what do you eat, right? Because in the past, I've done the extremes, right?
You mean when you get emotional and you want something like really satisfying for the emotions? Or what do you mean when things get tough?
That's pretty much what I mean, you know, because in the past I've done the extremes, you know, raw fruit for a while, and then the emotions hit, and then I just go eat potatoes, right, or chips. Absolutely. Which is not good. And I'm
I have to agree with that. I had a handful of pistachios, and they were salted when I was emotional recently, and I saw them there, and I was like, oh, I'm gonna just have some of these. And it just kind of settled me, because when I'm really detoxing, like today, all I've had is I've had my herbs, I've had a cacao, like a hot cacao, like a little one, and mixed with like reishi mushroom and like different. I made an elixir, I'll share with y'all one day the recipe, and some coconut, like warm, like heated up coconut milk. And then I just like drank Concord grape juice and lemon all day, and then just had a soursop, like one of my favorite fruits, before I came on this call. And I mean, I've been super emotional all day. I went to see my sound therapist, and we did some really deep healing work. And I literally just have been crying all day. This is kind of why I look like this. Not that I feel like I have to excuse how I look, you know, if I'm just comfortable, but
you look great.
Thank you. But definitely, like, it probably shows that I've been crying. So I do want to answer. We did have one question before we say our goodbyes. We have a question. Thank you, Christina. She asks about, there's a bunch of comments I missed. Sorry, guys. She asked about, we can get to it after in the comments. We will answer any questions that you had that we didn't answer here live. But she asked about leaky gut. And I just want to say, this is a false thing, guys. This whole thing, I believe, is made up. I mean, what I learned back in the day from a naturopathic doctor, this beautiful Italian doctor, Gaetano Morello, he taught me quite a bit at the time, but it was before I was introduced to these healers that I've trained with. And he taught me about leaky gut, and I believed it wholeheartedly at the time. And it was helpful because I was able to understand that my body needed probiotics to protect the lining of my GI tract. Right. But the thing is your body creates its own probiotics by eating living foods, number one. And number two, if there's really such thing as leaky gut, you're going to emergency, dear one, if you have leaky gut. Dr. Moore said he had one incident in all his, you know, 40 years or so of practice, where he had a client come in, and on his breath, he could smell fecal matter. On the guy's breath, and he sent him to emergency, and that guy was leaking out. So that's my answer to your question, dear one. I think if you want to work with the GI tract, we work with taking off the mucoid plaque. If anything, it's nothing's getting through there because there's so much mucus that the body formed to protect itself. You know, when you ate gluten or cooked offensive foods, you know, I'm not totally free of myself. The body likes to create this mucus to protect the lining. So there's no way that there's holes in the lining, because otherwise you're going to be really sick. So I thank you all for tuning in. Pascal, any last thoughts on that?
No, leaky gut sounds pretty horrible.
It's almost as bad as the nightmare we walk down when we follow the advice of the medical system when it comes to our health and well-being. So yeah. Of course, I respect emergency medicine and surgery, surgeons, you know, emergency surgery. I totally have so much respect for all these surgeons and doctors. I would say do not ask them too many questions, because if you're working with certain things, we can help you here and we won't take you down a path that leads to, you know, a living hell. So come over to Wellville with us. So much love. Thank you. If you want to go deeper, we offer coaching, private coaching, and just here to answer any questions in the group. You know, we like to have these complimentary calls every 2 weeks. So we're really here for you guys. Thank you so much for this endeavor to take your health in your own hands. Thank you, Pascal, for this. Thank you for helping
Thank
me.
Thank you. We'll see you at the private.
Private sharing circle for detox friends. We'll see you guys there in a couple of minutes. Just use the link in the comments. It's posted in the group, and or check the files, how to access our Zoom meeting, and it's all there for you. So we look forward to a nice little meditation and maybe some deeper shares. Lots of love. Thanks for joining us. Thanks, Pascal. Take care, guys.
Okay, see ya. Bye.
See ya.